Hello anybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Rogue Legacy. I'm Mr. Debius, or just Deeb, and in the last episode we challenged Johannes a couple more times and didn't have so much luck, and explored more of the castle. Not much other than that. And in today's episode we're basically going to be doing more of the same. So I think I'm going to reverse it up a little bit now. I'm going to go and tour throughout the castle, and then I'm going to challenge Johannes, just so the episode doesn't get like a weird length if we killed Johannes on the first try, and you know. Yes, I did re-roll, because I want to try a different character. Alright. So it's either going to be a paladin or a Hokage, and I think we're going to go with... with Sir Hornsby the second. No, we're going to go with Sir Cohen the second. Because we haven't actually played a Hokage in a little while now, and, you know, we could always afford to play as a Hokage. Increase our attack. And we're doing a nice amount of damage. I never noticed before, but the dummy's face changes. Not just his name, but his face. We don't have a lot of HP, but we do have a lot of MP. So we can do that a lot. I have a feeling this life isn't going to last very long. Just a feeling. Just a feeling. Also, dextrocardia, it's a little visually, like, hard to interpret. Because your HP and MP don't only switch values. I mean, they also kind of switch places on the bar above, so you can see that our mana bar is where our HP bar usually would be and all that. And that kind of interface screw does kind of play tricks on you. It's kind of hard to ignore. It's not a big deal, but it's not nothing. You know? That kind of interface screw is, again, just kind of part of what makes this really good. You know, it occurs to me, I don't think we've gotten the dyslexia ability yet. That's a fun one. Did we get dyslexia? I don't think we did. Well, if it ever comes up, we'll take it. In the meantime, yeah, I know I ran away from that room, but only because I'm more interested in getting down to the dungeon, as I said I was going to do. Now, we take care of those Sharites. I think they were called Sharites, or like little Sharons. Well, for right now, it's time for us to throw more axes. More axes! And... okay. Yeah! Very nice. Yep, you're out of targets, you can't run the gig anymore, and that means I get a reward of more money. Thank you very much, Mr. Clown. Also, the nice thing about playing as a Hokage, you're fast. We don't have HD, ADHD, but we're still nice and fast, so we can actually get through this place. Okay, I did not mean to teleport, I meant to do that. Because that's what the spike balls are for. The enemy is not the only one who can use their balls against us, we can also use our balls against them. I know what I said. All right. Nice and cleared out. Yeah, I know, I'm going the wrong way again. It's hard not to. Especially when it just takes a second to duck your head into a room, but then you're committed to it because you're like, well, I may as well clear it out now. And I know I've made this excuse a million times before, so I'm gonna head down. I'm heading down. Down, 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 to the dungeons below. Take no damage in this fairy room. Pretty easy. One sprint and one double jump will do ya. But we have two double jumps, so it's even better for us. And... whatever. Nobody saw that. Unfortunately, it looks like there's no easy way down into the dungeon this time, so... looks like we're gonna have to keep going right after all. At least it looks like we're gonna clear out most of the dungeon in this attempt. But we'll see. Ah, my nose itches. Okay, here we've got more fire traps. Nothing in particular. Where the heck is the entrance to the dungeon? It's really far over east. It's probably going to be, like, right next to the entrance to the forest. Although I wonder if we might have to go through the forest to get to the dungeon. Probably not. This goes into the forest, though. So, we should be close to another thing. another in-between area, I guess you could say. Now, before we go down into the dungeon, I want treasure. And it's not over here. Looks like it's gonna be up in the Maya again. It's always up in the Maya, always treasure, distracting me from where I need to go. And you know, doors distract me too from where I need to go. Basically everything distracts me from where I need to go. I'm just, you know, not great sometimes. Oh boy, what are we even gonna do in New Game Plus? Like, how are we gonna do it? Well, to be fair, when it comes time to do New Game Plus, I'm anticipating that the boss fights and all that aren't gonna take near as long. Like, the sections, it's not gonna take nearly as long to beat New Game Plus as it is taking us to beat the main game. So I'm expecting that to go relatively quickly. We'll see, though. And now we've reached the Maya. This is where we wanted to be. Took care of them. And we can't get in there because there's a little doorway right there that is meant for dwarf characters. Ooh, this is a dangerous room. Well, let's throw a couple of spike balls around and hopefully clear out some enemies, do some damage to a worgen, and there was a mimic on top of the normal chest. That was just rude. Clever, but rude. Okay, come here. It's dead. It's dead. Everything's fine. This is not a real chest. Always keep an eye on that map, but don't keep both your eyes on the map at all times, because that's an easy way to get yourself hurt real bad. It's true, though. If you heard a thump, that was me adjusting myself in my chair, so don't worry about that. I don't know why you would worry about that. Maybe Mr. Devious fell out of his chair. Maybe he's dying even as he continues to do this Let's Play. Rogue Legacy has really brought out the weird in me. Hasn't it? Maybe. I can't even tell. We'll go up when we need to go up. And I just decided that I wanted to go up to get over here because this is the direction we need to go to get over to the treasure. But okay, we should clear out this room first, just for the sake of our own safety and sanity. And now I'm down here with a jukebox in an area with music that I already like. Okay, we'll go up from here and use that to our advantage. Clear out the enemies. Now, I did trash talk the Hokage a little bit in the beginning by saying something along the lines of, like, once your assassin gets a really high crit chance, the Hokage levels off. Well, in the main game, they stay useful. And even in the late game, they're still technically useful. But once your crit rate is super high, it's more about the crits than it is about, like, you just your raw damage. Hokage does stay useful for a really long time. And they do most, and a big part of that is also their speed, because they are really fast. Now, I have to be careful because my careless attitude has gotten us really badly damaged. And that's not good for us at all. Hey, chicken. Thank God for that. Got ourselves a little more HP back. That's good, we're sitting a little more pretty. Okay. We can have some chicken and food. Unfortunately, since we have very low HP, that means that the chicken isn't going to do a whole lot for us. And, you know, hits like that will be even worse for us. But now we can head over. And, you know what, we shouldn't go up there. We shouldn't. We'll just get the treasure over here first. Oh boy, that's a wrath. It's dead though, so you know. And we made it to the treasure room, thank goodness. Getting lots of blueprints this way, and that's fantastic. See, this is why I think it's really worth it to always follow the compasses to their end, because when you get things like blueprints for the really rare armors and like the higher tier armors, that totally makes it worth it, because it can be a pain to get the later sets of armor in the game. It can be a little bit of a pain, at least. Okay, you're taken care of. It is nice to also send enemies flying with our ability, so that's entertaining. Okay, I think we can possibly take care of this room now. Really depends on the enemies that we have to deal with up here. Well, that's taken care of. This ninja tried to kill us. He didn't have so much luck, though, because now he's dead. What a world that we live in. And we killed the Wrath already, so we should be fine in getting this treasure chest. Very nice. Over here, we've got ourselves a big ol' room that leads to a dead end, so let's get down there. And also, you know, throw more spike balls down there. Oh! Treasure chest jumping up the hill. It's just funny to me. And just some guard with a spear, no big deal. But I need to stop it with this laid-back attitude before I go and get myself killed pretty much immediately again, because that's just how it goes in this game. That's how it always goes. And I'm in this situation again where, since I've already done so much of the Maya, I think to myself, yeah, you may as well finish it. You may as well finish it off. Also, that's cruel that those fell there. This room is very nasty. It's got a lot of spikes. Like, a lot of spikes. I don't get it. And this room also has a lot of spikes. Why is this Maya so spiky? Is this my ninja training? Or my Hokage training, excuse me very much. My shinobi training. That was a little frightening. Nearly jumped right up into them. Okay. Is this a blind spot? I think this is a blind spot. Blind spot. See, this is the kind of strategy you want to employ with Conflux. You basically swarm the map with so many balls that the enemies simply have no means of escape. And that through that means we can clear out a dangerous room like that and get all of that MP. Isn't it delicious and beautiful? Also, I think we've seen all of the developer games now, or like all of the notes for the developer's past games now, because we haven't seen a new one in several episodes. So that's interesting. Okay, ouch. Also, ouch. Unfortunately, it looks like this level still wants to threaten us quite a bit. Okay, and there's a mimic who wants our blood. He's dead, though. I think that Ninpo is dead, too, come to think of it. This room just has a ridiculous amount of enemies. Nope, that would have killed us, straight up. Okay, got ourselves another treasure chest there. Ninjo is dead. Another false thing. I was really hoping for more money after all of that, but I guess beggars can't be choosers when it comes to raiding a castle for treasure. Right. That's just the way it is. Alright. It looks like we've gotten most of the Maya done. There's just a little bit left near the entrance that we need to pick up on the way out. Whoa. Okay. And we're out of there. Just need to teleport back over to... There. And stock up a little bit on some HP and MP. Is there anything in here? There's a little bit over here. Wonder what it is. Whoa. There's a treasure chest further on in this room. And we should be able to reach it. Yep. Got a nice amount of scratch. Nice, delicious money. And over here is a much bigger room. My goodness. And I can already tell that there is one of these dudes, Pyrite, chasing after us. It's dead, though. As are these ninjas. So let's head into the upper area before we do the bottom left, just to get this out of the way. That Worgen died before I could even properly process it. And that's why it's sometimes good to just kind of blindly swing your sword. Sometimes. I can't think of a lot of disadvantages for wildly swinging your sword. Maybe in real life you shouldn't swing a sword around randomly, but we're not in real life, we are in video games. The nice thing about the Hokage also, their high damage against Hulk guards, that's still really nice. And after all that trouble, we have finally cleared out the Maya. The other areas should be a cinch, with that in mind. Also, was there something stopping us from getting that treasure chest in that other room? There must have been, otherwise why didn't I pick it up? Oh yeah, we're not small enough. So it goes. So it goes. For now though, it's back into the castle. And we can land right on a spike ball. That's great, that's just fine. I don't mind landing on spiky balls. It's fine. Everything's fine. Got ourselves a dead end in here. It also looks like we're just gonna clear out the castle just by merit of walking around with that the way we are. Like, I may as well go over to the left side here. Yeah, it's a big room, all right. Mostly for this fire trap that's above, but threatening? Nah. The fire's too slow and the enemies are weak, so even when they do damage, which is rare, they're not gonna do much. But let's not get impatient on the way out and take a few dumb hits, because we don't really have that much health to spare here. And this is the only way forward other than that other path I could have teleported to on the left. Shut up, I forgot about it. Well, it's okay. It's good that I've... Hedgehog's Curse. Wonderful. Wonderful. It's what I always wanted. That's exactly what I wanted on this character. That's fantastic. That is just... beautiful. I pray that I find another... that I find another shrine to pray to, because I swear to God... like, I'm not even gonna... I can't reasonably go down into the dungeon now with the Hedgehog's Curse. I don't want to. I do not want to. And that's all there is to it. Because I'm more likely to get hit down there and lose my money really fast. Whereas at least in the forest, I have more of a chance of actually getting to get a different thing, a different shrine to pray at. So I guess in the end we did do the dungeon in the end, but blame the compass and the... not the the compass and the Hedgehog's Curse for that, because seriously, also blame me because I'm a coward. Well, if nothing else, Alexander's boss door is here to greet us, and we do like Alexander's boss door. It's not as familiar as Kidder's boss door, but it is what it is. Which in and of itself is kind of a useless statement, like, it's super redundant, and I hear a lot of people say it is what it is in response to, like, bad things happening, or, like, people being bad, and it's like, well, it is what it is, but it's like, does it have to be the way it is? Does it really? Philosophical and social commentary in your Rogue Legacy Let's Play. I know, right? You love it, right? Well, there's no refunds. Or rather, you can have a refund, but you didn't pay anything. Because my episodes don't, they're not monetized, they don't make money. You don't gotta watch an ad, I hope, unless this is monetized, but it shouldn't be. Because as far as I know, the creators of Rogue Legacy made it totally kosher to Let's Play their game. Which was really cool of them, by the way. Thank you, Cellador Games, for totally being with the times. You know? That's really important for companies these days, and a lot of developers still cling to the idea that, you know, Let's Plays are bad, or like they're entitled to the money that Let's Plays make. And there's the whole debate on, what's the word? Fair use and what makes a diversive product, not a diversive product, but not derivative, but basically what makes a piece of work its own thing. And that's a whole debate all itself, but, you know, I've always been of the mind that Let's Plays, that, you know, players can offer their commentary, and it's only, for the most part, unless your game is terrible, and the Let's Player is talking terrible things about it, then there's not really much to lose in that case. I do think it would be annoying to have a Let's Player who would talk only about themselves and totally ignore the game. And I can see that from the point of the developers. If they make this wonderful game that they put all this time and effort into, only for it to be talked over by somebody who puts like slaps a picture of themselves bigger than the game itself. Like, I don't have a problem with people using webcams to record themselves as they play, but there is a big amount of putting the person before the game they're playing. And I know for some people some people go to Let's Plays channel specifically for the people who play the games, and I think that's true a lot of the time, but I really want to hear about the game, usually when I watch a Let's Play. Like, I go there for the people, of course you're there for the Let's Players, but I'm also very much there for the game. And there are Let's Players who I won't watch Let's Plays of because I'm just not interested in the game they're playing. I can't believe we're not doing so well on this one. Oh well, we still have 4 knives left and 4 targets left. I can't believe I miscounted that other time, by the way. That was embarrassing. As is this, and we're out of money. Yeah, I know, I couldn't hit the 8 targets. I know I failed. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Booyan. I tried my best. It just wasn't good enough. It's hard. It's hard to get the timing down. Now we're back in this room. No, I did not mean to teleport. I meant to just shower this room with balls. More balls. Balls for everyone. Spiky balls. And that completes all of the enemies, so that's a fairy chest for us. It was worth it. Conflux has been really useful for staying out of the way of danger, and especially in the big rooms, where, you know, you really gotta throw yourself in there otherwise. I think we're almost done with the forest, though, and then we can head down to the dungeon. First, in here, take no damage? Yeah, I don't think that's gonna happen, not in here. And if I take damage in there and money goes flying everywhere and I'm scrambling to pick it up, that's just gonna be a bad time. And I forgot that they were short enough to run through the frickin' flat area. Ugh. Worgens! Worgens are jerks. And the money disappeared. Everything's bad. And you, sniper, even though you're a tier 3 enemy, you're not that bad to deal with because you only got 3 arrows, and that's really not that bad to deal with. Whoa! And in here, we just have, you know, a pretty long path. But not much in it. Just some spikes and some guards. Sadly, it doesn't look like we're gonna get another altar to pray at, or a... That's never fun. It's never fun to have to pick up all your money again. Oh, that's annoying. And it looks like we're not gonna really have any way of fixing our hedgehog curse before we leave. This is a terrible room to be stuck in. Oh boy, I think I might actually die. Yeah, I might have actually died there. Because those spike balls are just... It's hard to see them when you're going down. It's genuinely difficult. Well, we'll hop over that. Come down here. And we're actually going to have to go around a little bit to get back to the most recent teleport that we can use. So let's be careful on the way out not to get hit by something like that. I'm just so cautious now. Okay, now we're back into the castle itself, and we're heading down because that is our only option. And our only option from here is to go down into the land of darkness. We're gonna die. We are, holy crap. Well, that was really nothing I could have done about that. I did not have the, like, reflexes for that. That was really lame. Really lame way to die. Not happy at all. But oh well. We killed a ton of enemies, and we made a ton of money despite the failure that we had to deal with, so I'm not too upset about it. Now, let's cycle the characters again. And okay, let's try out a barbarian, Lady Blair III, against Johannes, because we are going back to fight Johannes again. And also, we do have more equipment to buy, so let's get ourselves the dragon helm. More health, more mana. And the dragon chest. But we need to be able to carry a little more before we can put that on. Well, let's do it then. Okay, we can now carry the dragon chest. Isn't that gorgeous? We've almost got a full dragon set, all things considered, and that's pretty cool if I do say so myself. Look at how badass we are at this point. Super cool. Increase our chance for death defy, and increase our HP. And our magic. And our skinny barbarian is ready to go and take a shot, take a stab at the enemy up ahead. We're balding. And we're so slow after a Hokage. I know, Johannes. I know. I know you have to do this speech for every descendant who comes in here before you kill them. But that's just the way it goes. And as you can see, the blade wall is very nice for getting Johannes to keep his distance from you. But don't get confused with his... Don't get him confused with, like, his swords. Now, the nice thing here is that you can shout away his magic if it gets a little too much to deal with. And on top of that, you can blow him away, too. And with... He's getting a little shaky and weird. Is that just me? We're actually doing all right here because we actually have the health to be able to take a lot of these hits. Let's give ourselves a little bit of room here. However, we are going flying with every hit, so that's a little frustrating to deal with. This run's actually going pretty well. We might actually have a victory on our hands. And he tried to jump over our sword wall and threw it. Thankfully, he doesn't seem to have very good AI when it comes to dealing with the sword wall. Come on. Come on. Get over here. Yeah? Ouch. And we got him!
You think you have slain me? I have lived for over 1,000 years, and I will live for 10,000 more. Alexander, Kidder, Ponce de Leon, I was not the first hero to reach the fountain, but I will be the last.
Uh-oh. Johannes the Fountain. This is the true final boss of Rogue Legacy, so get yourself your health back, because it is time to battle the final boss, the Fountain. Can we do it? I think we can, if we don't make bad mistakes. Which we seem to be doing against his moves. Okay, no more of this. Look out for the giant sword. Now, I actually think that this phase is a lot easier than the first phase of the fight, because a lot of his moves have a lot more, they're a lot more projected, so it's just a lot easier to kind of figure out what he's gonna do. And he's not as fast, so it's just easier to deal with, in my humble opinion. However, we do have to deal with a lot of projectiles, and when he teleports into the middle, that can be a little frustrating. It can be. That's a nice way to get rid of those, though. And because his attacks take a lot more wind-up, you get a lot more ground to be safe in. Okay, come on. Whoa, 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 whoa. And he raises his sword up above again. Oh boy, ouch. We can't take another hit. And the fountain caught up to us and beat us into the ground. We have been slain by the fountain. Still, we got to see the second stage of the fight. Let me check the time. All right, here's what I'm gonna do for this last life. I'm gonna try to get down into the dungeon, and then if we survive the dungeon, I'm gonna go straight to Johannes, just in the interests of making a reasonable length video, you know? And for this task, we are going to call upon, not the Lich Queen, because it's a little lich going down into the dungeons and they're not gonna survive. We're going to call on another barbarian. We're gonna call upon Sir Lee the Second. It's been a while since we had a Lee. Oh, wait, are you the... Yeah, you're the second. Yeah, the Lee was the first one that we sent into the castle by ourselves. It would kind of be fitting for this to be the guy who finished off Johannes, but that's just not going to be the way it goes. So, priorities. We get down to the dungeon. We try to, you know, kill whatever's down there. And then from there, you know, we go on and fight Johannes. You already know my plan, and you can discern my plan. Now I'm trying to focus on this nonsense. It's going better than usual, though, I gotta say that. Okay. Alrighty. Almost. Almost. Almost! Almost! Okay, we're down to our last knife, though, so I don't think this is gonna go great for us. Yeah, we had one target left. Yeah, you think you're hot stuff, but you know, I don't see you down in the dungeons, suffering. Alright, Surly, you're huge. Enormous, really. And I wandered off from the way to go to get to the dungeon, but I don't care. It's just what I do at this point. I'm not wandering too far, I just want treasure, okay? It's really hard to ignore the temptation of treasure. Okay. Alrighty. And now we can start heading back down into the danger that awaits us in the pits below. And also just kind of smack everything out of our way with, like, a nice meaty slap. A meaty slap from a sword, I know, but don't question it. Don't question the meat sword. This is getting weird. Lots of enemies in here, though. But not too much, not too big of a deal to deal with. And this is just a dead end, but there's treasure up above, and I want it. So we're gonna get it. Despite the consequences that have awaited us, or that await us in this room. The nice thing is that since our barbarian has so much... Barbarian? Our barbarian has so much health now, every piece of meat is a great boon to just recovering so much HP now. It's fantastic. And you know, we're huge. I just like being huge. It's one of my favorite traits in the game. It's just a lot of fun to be huge. And from here, we should have our entrance into the Land of Darkness again. Alright. Don't do that. And our high crit chance is also really paying off now. Now we're just going to... We're going to play Ponce de Leon's boss theme, because I like it. And it kind of, hopefully, maybe the music will, like, get me to pick up the pace, because it's frantic and explosive, and maybe we'll get through here more quickly that way. Maybe. No promises. Hey, look at that, though. We found Herodotus's boss door. So you know what? We're gonna head in, fight him. This very unique boss, Astrodotus, Lady Echidna versus Astrodotus. In this fight, it's asteroids. It's frickin' asteroids, and you gotta play as a dragon. So this is actually the most different boss fight of all of them, because now Herodotus is in a constant jump and never landing and cycling through the other sides. So the main strategy here is also kind of the same one you want to employ against normal Herodotus, is you want to, you know, you want to focus on one thing or like one blob without splitting too many of them up, otherwise you just have too much to deal with. And you know, you don't want too much to deal with. So you want to effectively take care of these things. But it's hard to do that. It's easier to do here because you don't have mages to worry about, but in the main fight it's more difficult because it's more frantic, you don't have as much free movement, and it's just harder. Also, you can only take two hits in here. Like, and then the third hit kills you, so that's a fun time. So the main challenge here is it's mostly an endurance of not getting hit, and once you get hit once, it's really easy to get hit again. I don't expect we're going to win here, but for the first attempt, it's going pretty well. It's an endurance, though, is what it is. However, I guess if you could get chicken to fall out of any of these dudes, they might land in the middle, and that's a good time. Oh man, I remember this being much harder though, and maybe that's just because my ability with shmup type encounters has improved a lot over the years. Oh boy. So, yeah. As far as things go, this could be going a lot worse. However, as you can see, the red ones are very aggressively like homing in on my position practically, and they're getting faster, they're getting nastier, and even though we got rid of all the green ones, I don't think we're gonna get rid of all the red ones. Oh boy. And we're dead. Well, whatever. It's fine. We'll take care of that in another episode, as we're gonna do with all the other mini-bosses, so we'll take care of it then. Ow. I do hope that those obels carry over into New Game Plus, though, because it's gonna be a pain rounding them all up again. Would you just... stop. Okay, this room, not a great start. We've already got knocked down to like 300 HP, and that could be worse, but it's not great, considering. There is just a lot of crap happening in this room, and it's not a great room to be a giant in. Thankfully, it's fun to still kill things. Whoa! Double zomboners on either side, that's never fun, just sudden zomboners on either side of you. It's like, what do you even do in that situation? Take no damage in this room. Easy peasy. See? We didn't even have to wait our turn, we could just use Fusro Da, or Daro Fus, or whatever this game uses instead of Fusro Da in order to avoid litigation. You know? Actually, I'm pretty sure Fusro Da is probably most definitely copyrighted. Why would they not copyright that? I don't know, though. Well, whatever. And this room's not too bad. The blobs are definitely much easier to handle when you have a giant sword to slap them away with. Now, where are we going? Going into a big ol' room like this, by the looks of it. It's nice that with a lot of the grounded enemies, you can just kind of let the spikes take care of them. Just knock them down there and let the spiky floor handle them. Oh boy. It's time to say oh boy again, because more enemies. And taken care of. Oh, there are more guard boxes in there. Not good. And there's nothing really down there except for spikes? Well, that's how you use the ground and the terrain to your advantage. You just kill them with the hilt of a sword. It's kind of silly, but in a fun way. You know, I don't feel like I'm cheesing so much as I'm being clever, and that's one of the nice things about Rogue Legacy, is when you figure out how to deal with a lot of situations in this game that not everyone may have thought of, you feel clever. It doesn't feel like you're cheesing, it just feels fair. It feels like you're smart for just thinking and considering that. It's not cheesing it at all. Okay, so that's at least one spike ball that vanished. I wish this one would go away. But we can't all have nice things. That's a lot of spike. That's a lot of... Well, that's exactly what Furo Dos is for. I think that's what it is. It appears above the head. You can see exactly what it is. I would look at it and read it, but I don't want to die, so I'm focusing more on what's actually around me than on the letters that come out of my head. Okay. My main thing with the fireball enemies, like the pyrites or them, is that they can be surprisingly sturdy considering what a small enemy they are, so that takes getting used to. Imperial chestplate. But we already have the dragon chestplate, so we don't really need the Imperial chestplate. But it'll look nice in our collection. Also, we've done a good job of clearing out most of the dungeon here. Right? I certainly hope so. Not much else to say in this room. It's just a bunch of spiky balls. What can you really say about that? The joke writes itself, if you're thinking of that. Just a bunch of dudes. Just lots of dudes. Lots of dudes and treasure chests we can't get to because we're so big. You can just... There. Get some health back. Can't get that money though, so that sucks. This is a take no damage room, which is just kind of a fast platforming challenge, but I'm not gonna do it because we're big and I don't trust ourselves to get caught in panic and just die. Look at this. Look at this fool. Thinks he can just sneak up on us and just hide out down there. Who does he think he is? Is there anything down here? Just a bunch of enemies. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoop, 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 whoop. This is a semi-challenging room. Lots of enemies to deal with. Could be worse, but it's not the worst. It's a reasonable challenge for the most part. It's mostly the eyeballs that put up a threat. Okay. And that hurts. And okay. Oh boy. We're almost done in here though. Won't that be nice? Dungeon's bigger than I remembered. Also, I'm not making as much money as I thought I would be. Well, so it goes. I guess I'm just crazy. I just thought I would make more money than I've been making. I have been making a lot of money, admittedly, but I guess I was expecting more. Oh well. Get out of here! Didn't shout in time. Alright. This top floor, it's annoying. And now, they're dead. So I hope they learned something, and we have cleared out almost all of the dungeon for real this time. Is this the last room down here? Not yet, but almost. We got ourselves a little more breathing room against all of these enemies here. Ugh. He almost made life more difficult for us. We gotta reach the treasure chest in here in like 5 seconds. Unfortunately, as you can see, we've already failed because, I mean, look, you can see for yourself that we failed. Oh well. We can still get some treasures and rewards for all of our hard times. We would have never made it to this thing without just dying, so it's just as well. But we did clear out the entire dungeon, and that's worth a lot. Because the dungeon is challenging. It remains challenging even when you get strong, because these enemies do continue to hurt a lot. And when enemies hurt a lot, there's not really much you can do for that. Now, I should go straight to the boss fight, but I want to restore a little more HP so I have a better chance against him. You know? Also, this episode probably got long just by doing the friggin' dungeon. Dungeon was big. And we're back down in the dungeon again. That was brilliant. Magnificent, really. Normally, in most other LPs, this is where I would do like a cut edit to somewhere else, but that feels weird to do in Rogue Legacy. Like, that feels not as appropriate. Like, every step is more important to document and to record. Yeah. Mostly I'm just, again, I'm trying to heal up a little bit so I can actually fight Johannes with a reasonable amount of health. That hurt. That hurt. Freaking jerk. Plus side, we got a bunch of health back. Not as much as I want, though. I want to be fully healed. Dude, I want a lot more health. Otherwise, I mean, I'm probably gonna die anyway, but you know, I want to go in there and actually have a shot at killing Johannes. You know? You don't just want to throw your life away. You want to give it your best shot. You want to prove to the world that you can do it. And I know I ignored that lamp when it might have precious meat, but sometimes you just gotta say to yourself, I don't feel like smashing that lamp, and by gum, I'm gonna stick to it. Don't take like life advice from me. I mean, you can, but it might be a bad idea. And on the plus side, we are almost back to full HP. We are getting there. A lot of these enemies are really, they really help with healing. Blobbies, and just a lot of small things. We're already almost back to 400. Freaking warg. And in addition to that, we can get ourselves an obol. Sharon, we don't need your obol right now. We just don't. We don't need to save that much money. Yet. There's no purchases that are really that drastically expensive right now that we need to save up money. But whatever. The gesture is nice. At least, I think. Come on, just jump up here. I know you're gonna jump up here. Fine. We'll do things your way, where I come down there and hit you with my sword. Freaking wargs, you can't predict them. Maybe the base wargs don't jump. Except that doesn't make sense because I remember wargs in Forest Abkhazia jumping and killing me when I was here to kill Alexander. So, you know, a pox on that idea. You know, come to think of it, I'm not sure if I've ever beaten this game with, like, a giant character, which just seems weird considering how good they've been this run for me. Even the one who killed Herodotus was endomorphic, so he was still pretty big, too. And that's the other spiky, or the other blobby enemy that we haven't seen yet, the Tier 3, the Blubosaurus Rex. Their main gimmick, as you can see, is that they leave tons of fire trails around when they jump around, so they can gain control of the field very quickly if you're not careful. Okay, we've gotten ourselves a nice amount of HP healed up. Is it time to teleport back yet? Not just yet. Almost, but not just yet. Okay. Alright. Hopefully we don't end up in one of those stupid situations where, you know, I take more damage by being stubborn and not going to fight the boss, and then I have to go in with less HP. And we already failed the mission to, like, get up there with no fighting, but I don't care. Ah, never mind. What am I doing? I'm endangering myself with the way I'm playing. I'm getting mad. Plonky! Plonky's a jerk. Because now I'm back to under 400 HP. It's my own fault. But I... Okay, let's pray for something else. Okay, Helios's blessing. That would have been nice to get, like, toward the beginning, but whatever, I'll take it. Whatever enemies I run into now will give even more money. And we can take a few more hits. We're almost there, though. Almost. Oh, that's a... Oh, boy, this was not the room I wanted to fall into. This was not the right room to fall into. I came to the wrong town. That was silly. Come here, pupper. Whoop, and nearly jumped right into the giant spike. But no, we avoided that. Okay. And not a big deal. Lots of enemies in here. Not too big a deal to worry about, though. Because we killed him. Killed the eyeball. Killed the chain tor. Killed the scout. Bonk. Killed a headless horse. And killed the other headless horse. Great, fantastic. Do we end up clearing out the whole damn forest? Almost. Alright. Barring getting hit again, I think I'm just gonna, you know, bail. And try to get back to, Johannes now. But, you know, just need to be careful on the exit. Lest something dumb hit me. Meat? I don't need mana, I need meat. And over here we have, oh, the shrine that we prayed to, of course. We're just dashing through the halls. And up here is just, you know, fireballs and more damage to take, more damage to take. I'll stop shouting. Tall guard is dead. I know I said I was gonna go for it, but you know, my tenacity paid off because we actually found the proper entrance back into the castle. And with that, we can teleport all the way back to the entrance and face off. Oh, we're in here again. Interesting. I'm not sure why we're doing this. I'm not sure what triggers redoing this part of the dungeon. Maybe it's because I went to other parts of the castle. Maybe it's because I fought Herodotus's twin, or his alternate version. That seems like the most logical version, because I can see there being like a coding thing where it's like, if the last boss you fought was Johannes, then you have to, you don't gotta do all this part again. Or maybe it just triggers if you don't go immediately to the door and just gives you stuff to heal off of. Also, yes, you can read any diary entry now. Oh, hello, Johannes. You're looking rather small. I'm sorry, I don't want to fight you, but apparently we do. We don't even want the Fountain of Youth, apparently, because you destroy it, but whatever. It is our job to basically, you know, teach you that what you did was wrong. Whoa, boy. Now, gigantism is really useful against Johannes, because when you're bigger than Johannes, that means your sword outreaches his. And again, I think the most dangerous thing about fighting Johannes is the fact that his sword does have more reach than yours does, usually. But when you're giant, of course, he doesn't so much have that advantage. Now, what he likes to do is he likes to try to back you into a corner, and that's one of the reasons you want to have, like, extra jumping in this fight, potentially. Even though I took that off in my fight with him, because, like, you know, it's just what I do. And we've almost got him again. We've almost got him. Ah! Got him in a corner. And he's down. I do think I have slain you, but as you can see, that's not going to be the case. He says the names once more. And once again, we stand against the fountain. I do like how he was able to collapse the fountain, or put the fountain back after we killed him the first time. Here comes the spikes from above, but we're giants, so suddenly it becomes a lot easier for us to do this, with extra reach on our sword, so stay out of the middle of the room, because he will just, he'll fill that up fast. Also, he doesn't take knockback, so you can't block him with, you know, you can't block him with a blade wall or anything like that. Avoid his sword swing, because while it hasn't hit me, I'm pretty sure it would do a crap load of damage. Also, Barbarian Shout is super useful in this fight. Just getting to knock away all of his projectiles is super useful. And this extra range is doing us a wonder, because as it turns out, whoa! Johannes, you might be strong, but the family has grown stronger.
have defeated me. But at what price? I may have slain the king, but only after he betrayed his people. Ask yourself what justice has been met. In the end, we are all guilty of the same sin. Look to your forefathers. Such is the cost for unquestioned loyalty. The sun. I had forgotten how it feels.
And I love this boss death. I love how it's just Johannes gets the same death as everyone else in the family. The fountain has been slain by Sir Lee II. How fitting. And that's even the fountain's parting words. He explodes into money. And with the Fountain of Youth destroyed, our prize gathered, and Johannes slain, it's time to go home. And now we get to see all of our stats for everything we've done for all the enemies in the game. We did not fight a McRib. We never saw them. We killed a lot of golden skeletons and a lot of these gray knights. As you can see, we were quite the murderers. Interestingly, we ran into more pupils than scouts, but that's an interesting thing about this game. Also, yes, the bosses get portraits. It's just an interesting thing about this game that sometimes the tier 2s are more common than like the tier 1s. Like, it's just funny. However, of course, in this case, we saw a lot of these. There were more of the tier 2 earth mages than the tier 1s from what we saw. Barbados and Amon, we killed 10 of each. The zombies, for some reason, they're stuck in the ground. I don't know why they don't come out fully in their portraits. Portraits of portraits, that's hilarious. I love that. We didn't run so much into the mimics. Salos, of course, is the giant portraits to deal with. We only had to kill two of them, or only killed two of them, rather. We got the Rangers, we got the Furies, the Alexanders. Speaking of which, hello, Alexander, get back in your portrait. I do like the theme of portraits in this game and how it kind of captures the souls of, like, everyone who has died and their legacies who have come past. Botus, we had such good times against you. I say this like I'm saying goodbye and I'm gonna play New Game Plus, so, you know. Plantite, Bud, Flowermon. Stolas and Folklore. We killed 7 of these dudes? Surprised to hear that. Lots of Charites, lots of Pyrites, only 3 Infernites. Ponce de Leon, you are still the coolest boss fight in the game, I think. That's my opinion. Here we got more of these gray armor dudes. I'm surprised they weren't a boss, but in a kind of a way, Johannes and the Fountain were the boss, the fill-in for the armored dudes. We got our ninjas in their robes. Nino Pojo. And the bloobs are weird because they count every small one you kill as its own thing. Like Herodotus, we killed 17 of them, which means that Herodotus is made of 17 smaller units. Tower Guard. Tall Guard, Hulk Guard. Nightmare, Dark Stallion, Headless Horse. I know I'm just saying the names of enemies, but yeah. I really like Rogue Legacy. I don't really want to do like my final words for this because this isn't going to be the end yet. Johannes, we have slain one of, and the Fountain gets his own portrait too. And now we get ourselves the credits proper, where we get to see our hero walk home, and we get to see all of the staff as well in their own forms. So when you see the portraits throughout the entire castle, this is what you're seeing. Are Teddy and Kenny twins? And Glauber always looks in his portraits like he's got punched in the stomach, but no, he's just swinging a sword. You get to see our musicians. You get to see all of these people who don't get the armored suits because you can't just make that for everybody. Overall, though, I think we did quite well with our run through Rogue Legacy. Some people are good enough that they can get through it really quick without many lives. I'm sure, and I know that a couple people have already beaten the game on like the first life, but I'm not that good. But I think for what it is, I think I've done pretty well. I had a lot of divine lives, a lot of divine heroes, a lot of ones who did pretty well, but I mean, I have the advantage of having beaten this game several times before, so I can't brag too much. All in all though, Rogue Legacy is a fantastic game, but I'll have more to say on it when we see this credit sequence again. And we will see it again. And once you head home, you come back to your castle, and you get to see
your family. Hello, small family. I am your huge father. Don't you love me? I hope you love me. Look at their tiny little swords. 85 children. That's a lot of lives. And you know what? It's gonna be even more. Because now, as we come back to the start of the game, the title screen, Start Your Legacy Plus. But we're not going to be doing that now, because as we've beaten the game, it's time to give Sir Lee the Second a rest. And if you want to see us continue this adventure again, then I just hope to see somebody in the next one. Bye-bye!